Hey, hello, I'm Yolo. Welcome to the third part. Just a reminder, we are working on a video like this. Today we have a lot to cover, so let's start sculpting in Blender. I'm starting simple and adjusting her hair. I want to make more elaborate curls on the character's hair. Since we already have one, let's use it again. I'm duplicating it and placing it roughly at the old one. I will mirror the curl by pressing minus on my keyboard while holding the mouse cursor over the x-axis. Now let's remove the curl sketch we have made earlier. I'm adjusting the shape in the edit mode and mirroring with a mirror modifier. I decided to work on the main hair shape, and it seemed to me that the hair wasn't symmetrical, so I will go to the sculpt mode and then use symmetrize. I continue shaping the hair, correcting curl shape slightly. Since I'm currently working on the sculpted version of the character, I don't worry about the topology breaking in some places. I will make new topology later anyway. As you can see, I removed my 2D sketch from the additional camera view. I don't need it anymore. Shaping hair more. I go back to the body to work out the general shapes. Working on her face, and I'm still trying to make her cuter. Okay, this next step is really unnecessary for the sculpting process, but as I'm showing you my process, I decided to show it to you with all add-ons I'm using. This one called Quadrimesh. I use it to make a suitable topology for sculpting, but not for rigging. If you noticed, her cheeks were not perfectly smooth, and I really like my model to be silky smooth, so a clean topology will help us to get rid of this. But honestly, those changes are so small that it's almost invisible, so you don't really need this. I'm fixing the mouth topology, assigning multi-res modifier to subdivide the new hair model, and refining mouth shape. working on her head and neck shapes. Adjusting her hair shape once more. Unfortunately, generated topology is not perfect, as you can see it here, below her cheeks. Back to working on her body. Her face is the largest and most crucial element of the character, so I spent a lot of time working through it. I'm subdividing her body, sculpting it a little, and moving her arms slightly up. Now let's make a thumb from her arm. I will copy and scale it, then inflate and position it near the palm. She will not have separated fingers because her hands are too small to be so detailed. Refining her arm shapes a little bit more. Now let's add her shoes. Adding a cylinder and, as always, scaling it. I want her to have tiny, simple shoes. remeshing and sculpting. Then adding a mirror modifier. Okay, now let's work on her skirt. Her whole body looks too big to me, so I will scale it. Yeah, that looks much better. I will go on and quad remesh her dress too. In this case, it will give me very impressive results. That's because her dress is almost a cylinder. When I work, I try to jump from one part of the character to another as often as possible to look at everything with a fresh look. So I will bounce back to her hair. I'm fixing shapes here and there. Moving legs origin point closer to the pelvis and slightly rotating them. I want to add dark lines to her dress, so I am selecting loops and assigning a darker material. You can grow your selection with the Ctrl plus hotkey. Now let's create petals. I'm adding a sphere, remeshing it and roughly sculpting a petal. But for this one I want to have it a perfect topology, so I will make a retopology for it myself and then continue sculpting. Here is the second plugin. I use this one very often. It is Retopo Flow. But as always, you can do the same retopology with the Blender native tools. And if you are interested in a tutorial like that, please write it to me in the comments and I will do it. I'm assigning mirror and solidify modifiers. subdividing and adding a support loops. So here we go, we have a petal. I am moving the origin point to the petal base. And forming a necklace for our character by duplicating petals. And that's that! In the next part we will finish sculpting our character. Thank you for staying with me so long. See you very soon!